This video is going to show you how to properly set the COM address for SoMove for use with the RS-485 cable. The RS-485 cable offered by Schneider Electric is the TCSM-C-NAM-3M-002P cable. So, let's close this PDF file and let's launch SoMove. So in the Edit Connection section of SoMove is where you'll define the COM address. What you'll want to do before you modify any setting in here is you're going to want to launch your Windows Device Manager. You can use in Windows 10, you can right click on the Windows icon and then choose Device Manager. I have that cable plugged in, so if I look at the Ports section and I expand the ports, it's this cable here, the TCSX-C USB 485 cable. And on my PC, that cable has captured COM3 port. We need to know that because that's what we're going to populate in SoMove software. So Edit Connection, that will invoke the settings window, navigate to the advanced settings, and choose the COM port. In my case, it's COM3. And then you would click Apply. You can leave all the other settings at default, and then OK, and then Apply. Edit Connection and Scan, and I scan the network. Well, it finds an ATV drive attached. One key point you have to remember when you install SoMove, SoMove by itself is just the front end. It's the operating interface for connection to different various hardware products that Schneider offers. By itself, SoMove won't function. You have to install the optional DTMs, which is device type managers, depending on what hardware you're going to work with. We can see that I've installed the DTM libraries for quite an array of hardware. Without these DTMs installed, the SoMove software won't be able to recognize the device that we're connected to. So by comparison, we know the SoMove software is working, and we can see that it discovered the ATV drive. I'm going to show you on a virtual machine. Let's open that up. We have a virtual machine running here where I just installed SoMove. And if I click in this installation, there are no DTMs installed. I haven't installed any DTMs yet. So if I open up the Edit Connection and I capture, because this is on the virtual machine, let me capture that port. I'm going to go to the Windows Device Manager in this virtual machine. I'm going to look at the ports. And on the virtual machine, it captured COM3. Go to the gear. COM3. Again, leaving everything else at factory default and apply. So now this virtual machine has the correct COM port. If I scan the network, it doesn't find any devices. And that's because my cable is currently plugged into a device, but there are no DTMs installed. I have to navigate to the Schneider website and download the appropriate DTM. So www.se.com. We're just going to look for the ATV 9X DTM. And as I'm typing here, the software was already found. So I'm choosing that. And I need to download and install the ATV9XX DTM library. So let me download that. I'm going to open the folder where the download is present. And before I install that, I'm going to make sure SoMove is closed. So currently there are no DTMs installed. So I'm going to close SoMove. And I'm going to install that newly downloaded DTM. So we've installed the ATV9X DTM. And now if I launch SoMove again, SoMove is going to detect that there's been some additional hardware libraries added. The catalog has been modified. Do I want to update? Yes. It's adding the ATV9X catalog. So now SoMove has that type of hardware compatible. There it is now in my installed DTMs. And now if I use the edit connection and I scan, the software will discover it. So now my SoMove is compatible with ATV 9X type variable frequency drives. I also have a Lexium 32 servo drive in my office. I'm going to plug the cable into that and we'll go through the step one more time. I've now plugged the communication cable into a Lexium 32 servo drive. Again, knowing that we only have the DTM installed for ATV9X, if I do the edit connection and scan, no devices are found. And that's because the ATV DTM is the only DTM that's installed, so it doesn't recognize the Lexium 32 servo drive. So closing SoMove again, I'm going to open my web browser. I'm going to go to the Schneider website. I'm going to search for the Lexium 32 DTM. And this is the file I'm looking for, the Lexium DTM file. Now that we found the file we're looking for, we're going to download that. And I'm going to install the Lexium 32 DTM library to make SoMove compatible with Lexium 32 servo drives. The installation of the Lexium 32 DTM has finished. When I launch SoMove, SoMove will detect the newly added hardware catalog. If I go to list the device software installed on this PC, we now see that my SoMove installation is compatible with ATV9 and Lexium 32 devices. So if you want to connect to an ATV312, you have to add the DTM for that. If you want to connect to a telesys device, you have to add the DTM for that. You can add as many DTMs as you want to make SoMove compatible with as much hardware as you want it to be compatible with. Now if I go to the Edit Connection Scan, Modbus Serial, and Scan Networks, it now finds the Lexium 32 drive. So in summary, install SoMove, check the COM port settings in Windows to discover what COM port the USB cable captured, COM3 in this example. In the Edit Connection Scan settings, in the advanced settings of SoMove, set the COM port address to match the COM port of the device that was captured in Windows. Then add the DTM device type manager library for the hardware that you want SoMove to be compatible with. Once you've done those steps, you should be able to use SoMove to commission the device you want to work with. I hope this video was helpful. Thank you for watching.